Just see, the burial team is under case management, and it consists 8 people. Out of the 8 people, there are just 2 people who are left out under this case management, but the 6 are here in this. But the 2 are the ones which are under this case management. So I just request that out of these 20 people under case management, they can just add 2, the mortality and he's left outside, and then it consists 8 people. And then they will be carrying out that what that activity. It's not that somebody on the barrier team will carry out only that barrier team, the duties of the barrier team only. He can do even the case management. He can handle patients in the eye, in there. So he is on the work.
Okay.
Then another thing.
Continue volunteering as part of your ethic and code of conduct, so that you can save lives for these patients, both COVID and non-COVID, because this is a facility that attends all the patients. On the list of challenges, please do compile them, bring them to our attention, we should try to see what we can handle and see what we cannot handle. Kagame Hospital previously had a budget of 41 million. I am happy it is less than 2 years then when our budget has been increased to 130 million every quarter. So since the budget has almost tripled, some of these issues can be handled by the facility itself. What is important is how best do we put this money for purpose. So make the list as they said, then we shall see how we are going to handle, and with time, those that we cannot manage shall be referred to the same.
Not make any mistake or any step in reaching out to the barrier team. Why am I saying this? I'm saying this because we've been suffering with dead bodies everywhere. So my request is one, careful with bear me witness. I'm requesting you, whether what or what, whether there is a dead body or not, to make sure you involve the mortuary group, the mortuary attendant in this group. Because we've been suffering with dead bodies everywhere. When you leave out the mortuary attendant or the mortuary department, that person will keep the intent to keep away. You know how they behave. And you know their personalities. They drink like a little, but I don't know why. I'm sorry to mention it. Careful, Lord. So, what I'm requesting, please.
Yes. For eventualities. Like our community is not yet fully sensitized. In the event they refuse to burn, we shall get stuck. So, whereas we may not emphasize so much about it, but let it be constituted, isn't it? And be put in place just in case there is an emergency, there is a body, a suspected body of COVID, and maybe the community has refused to bury. We don't want to get embarrassed, like something I saw on social media, where the community dropped a coffin in the middle of the road. You have seen it somewhere. I don't know whether it was true. Was the high was Mutian. So what happened? So I would beg that whereas we're not emphasizing it, we are going to sustain the community. It's unfortunately our health educators.
The barrier team will not be very much used in this COVID pandemic. The reason is dead bodies from a COVID patient do not transmit infection. You know the mode of transmission. They through droplets from the nostril or the open mouth. A dead body does not sneeze, does not cough. Maybe on the body, what is recommended is the health worker prepare the body. Pray. Put it in a body bag, okay, and hand over. Okay. And the barrier team were used in COVID, Ebola, but not in this COVID. Because the government, of course, this is a nationwide thing. It's not going to be able to meet what is required, like the PPE. Look at the team, it's about 8 people.
if you get like 20 people, the personal protective equipment, the gadgets we use to put on to approach these patients, we don't have. We do not have enough gloves to use. The N95 mask, there is a special type of mask, that one. Sister Tate is putting on. That's the type to approach these patients. But what have we been using at this time? Don't you think we are risking our lives? That's why when we talk of risk allowance, it must be possible. Another thing I would like to tell you, Chairman, is that this response is voluntary. All these people you see have accepted to work. Nobody has been forced in this thing. People have accepted to respond. Therefore, as they respond to save the lives of others, we should also give them something. Like you see, you was talking of large.